So today we'll be learning about the basic of first unit about database management system. So if I split this into three parts, so it will become database management system. So what is database? A raw collection of data of similar object. So a data which has been scattered way, so it is in a form of scatter. That means it is disturbed and it is denormalized. That means it has been not arranged properly. So not arranged properly. So scatter, denormalization, not arranged, all like we have been collecting that some similar data. Once this has been data has been collected, we are going to process. How it will be processed? With the help of our software. We'll take the help of the softwares. We are going to write some programs, some store procedures, schemas. Like this, we're going to write some for storing the data with the help of the software. So the data has been processed. So it will be stored under the database. Stored on your computer, okay, on computer or a server. So whenever I need it, I can get in a form of through the same software, I'm going to get the output. So I'll be requesting or I'll be processing my data with the help of software to store in the database, and whenever I need, I'll go and retrieve it, and whenever I want, I can update it. So what is happening here? I am trying to update, manipulate the data. Okay, I need some updations, some changes are required. I'll be going to do it. Okay, I'll be storing. So I need to be stored. I need to be retrieved. So when such kind of things happens, we need a design. Design for what? A database. So when I'm designing the database, how it should be, what is the object? So how I'll be designing the database? First of all, I have to identify the data. So if I identify the data, I have to process. So for this processing, I have to identify the scattered one should be arranged. So in order to arrange that scattered data, first So I have to find the object among the data. So in the data, what are the entities or object? Both are the same. So we called in a terminology, in DBMS terminology, as an entity. Normally we call as an object. Okay, so we are going to identify the data of similar objects, and from this I'll be identifying the how I can store this particular data. Suppose if I take the pen, now pen is an object. Okay, now here I'll be saying something called this is my power bank, this is one object. Okay, so I have been getting all the data like this. I have been collecting some data. Now I have to segregate from this what I can do with this. Okay, how I'll be identifying the identity. So I'll be saying this is a power bank, this is a tiffin box, this is a pen. Okay, so like this, I'm trying to identify the entity from the existing data. So I have been finding a similar object. So these are all our objects. Okay, so how it will link to each other, we'll be seeing the learn in the coming soon. Okay, so what is happening over here? We are getting the entity. So once we got an entity been identified from the data, then we are trying to design the database. So we have to design the database because we have to store the things in the form of software. I have to store in my hard disk or on the online or somewhere I have to store. So if I want to store, I need a design. So when I'm saying design, we call this design as a schema. So we are going to create a data schema. How we are going to create? By saying the diagram. Say I have been identifying something like in front of you, I have done all the objects I have been getting over here. So I've been identifying the object. Then I'll be saying, sir, okay, I have a tiffin box. So I'll be saying, I have a tiffin box. Okay, I have a pen. I have a paper. Okay, I have a power bank. Like this, I have been getting an object. So what I'll do, I'll try to design the database. So in order to design the database, I say that in entire database, now overall database. Now say I have this entire thing. I want to create an entire database for this. So if I want to create a database, we call that as a design. If I'm design this, if I'm able to design this entire thing for this database, then it is called as a schema database. Okay. So how I'll be designing? First, I will take the tiffin box. So I have been identified. This is an object. I'm saying this is an object. This is an object. This is an object. So in our DBMS terminology, we call this as an entity. So I have been able to identify the entity. So what is my entity now? I'll be trying to draw the structure. So I want to draw the structure. So I'll be saying structure. How the structure I have to do? So tiffin box is the name. So I have been seeing this. Okay, we'll be able to say the tiffin box. So tiffin box is my entity. Okay. So what do you find in this structure? So a tiffin box have ID. Say I'll say I want this ID because I want the numbering for, because if I want to sell it, I need some identification to sell it. Okay. Then I'll be having the color for this. Then I have the size. Okay. Then I have something called quantity. Then I'll be having something called price. So I got a tiffin box as an entity. Then I'm able to identify the, I'm trying to design the structure. Now when I'm designing this structure like this, then we call this as a data modeling. Because we are trying to give the one picture to this. So you have been got all the items that have been thrown or somewhere, it has been disturbed, you have been scattered, you want to arrange it. In order to arrange this particular object of similar objects, what we call as a database, that we have been framing into a structure. So when I'm making into a structure, so as I told, first you have to design it. So once you design the database, you call it as a schema. Okay. Then when you design the structure, we call that as a data modeling. So once the structure has been designed, now this is the structure of the tiffin box. Okay. Now I'll go for the another one. I'll be saying the another structure is what, another entity. What do you have here? We have something called pen. So I'll be saying pen is an entity. Then again, I will be having for this, a pen has the ID. A pen has the brand. Then we have something called color for this. Then we have the quantity, then price. Okay. Then manufacture unit or the place. Okay. Like this, if you want as many of things, again, you can have this. So this is about the pen. So again, I have been creating a data modeling for the pen. So this has also become the data modeling like this. I have created the multiple data modeling. Then I have been given total entire picture of all the entities. So I have been identified in front of me four objects I have been find. So in my thing, I have been getting four objects. So I have been identified four objects, and this based on this, I have been designed the structure, what we call as a data model. So once the data modeling has been got cleared, then we call that as an entire thing as a schema. Okay. Now, what do I do with this schema? With the help of the schema, I'll be taking an help of DBMS language. I'll be going to take the help of the DBMS language because I have to store. Because this part, whatever you have seen, the data has been processed. So what I have been doing process, before processing, I have to make arrangements, all the arrangements. So I have been identifying the schemas, I'm designing the structure and all things. Now I have to use the software. So if I want to use the software to store the database into my database, what I have to do, it should be processed. So for that, I have to take the help of the structure. So these diagrams are going to help me to use the software. So my software will going to take care. Okay, this is what he wants to do. So I have got a rough idea about what I can do with this object. So with this particular object, I can able to know, I have been identify the characteristics of this. So we call these are the characteristics of this particular entity. So tiffin box is an entity, and ID, color, size, quantity, price are the characters of this particular tiffin box. So in our DBMS terminology, we call all this as an attributes. We call this as an attribute. So here also pen is an entity. So this is an entity. We call this as an entity because it's an object. So tiffin box or a pen is an object. Then it has some characters. So we call this all characters as an attributes. So we call this as an attributes. Okay. The designing what you are doing, we call that as an data modeling. Now I have to store this in a database in my computer. I want to store it. So I need something called a language. Say the language which we are using is something called DDL. Then we call something called DML. We have something called DCL. We have something called TCL. Like this, with the help of this particular languages, I'll try to put it into the system. So what I need the to be know about the programming language. I should become a programmer. Okay. With the what I'll do, I'll in order to learn the program, I have to know that what the software I'm using, how I'll be going to interact with that particular, so that this reality can be converted into database. So the object which has been shown to you, how I can be converted into real information, because ultimate my target is that I have to process the data, and whenever I need, I can update, I can retrieve, and I can store. So I need the ultimate target is I need the final output as an information. Okay. So I need the information. So the data which has been processed using the software to store into the database. Finally, what I'm getting the output as an information. So when I'm getting the information, with the information, I can do a lot of things. Okay. So I can try to manufacture the more product like this. I can improve my product, or I can do in the top one in the market. So with the help of this information, I can do whatever I like. It depends upon the usage of the users. So how it is required to that particular person, this information. So I need to know about the DBMS language. So a programmer has to interact with the software to convert this one. So how I'll be going to do this? What I'm going to do with this languages? Languages will going to help us something like I have the schema. So I'll be having, as I told you about what is the schema. Schema is in a design, overall design of the database. So once I have been designed it, it has objects like, so the schema objects are something like tables, something like views, something like stored procedures, something like constraints. Okay, so with the schema, with the design, the structure, the data modeling, after getting the data modeling, what I can do with the data modeling, I will going to create the tables, I will going to create the views, I will be going to create storage procedures, I will going to create the constraints. To create all this, I need DBMS language. So the topic says data management system. So database is that one. What you have done, you have created that all the structures, designing, understand the concept, data modeling you have been doing. This is about the database. Then after doing this, I should be know about the language. So for this, I need some system. Okay. So the system which is going to manage my data, that is what the database management system. Okay. So we need some software. The software will going to help me to create the tables, views, stores, procedures, and constraints. So these are all are the objects of the schema. So I can create the schema, I can create the table, I can create the view, I can create the stores procedure, I can create the constraints. When I'm saying the table, a table is the collection of rows and columns. Okay, so collection of rows and columns. That means I will be going to store my data in a form of record. So this entire row, we call this as a record, or I'll be calling this as a tuple. Okay, in our DBMS language, we call this as a tuple. When we call this as an a, this one, columns, we call this as an a columns, or we call this as an a domain. Okay, so in the DBMS terminology, the terminology is changing. In our normally, we will be saying this as a columns and the rows and columns. So we will be storing the database So this entire one row, the entire row is belongs to one person. The entire row is belongs to second person. The entire row belongs to the third person. So each row is called as one record. Okay, that one record, when I'm trying to retrieve that record for the person. So how I'll be retrieving, it's depend upon your query. You are going to put some questions. Say I have a lot of columns. I don't want all the columns, though it is been used for some other person. I need something like student ID and name because I want to take that. And some people wants to know about his contact number because he has not paid the fees. So the administration or the fee section wants his contact number and his roll number so that he'll be good. So he is having roll number. With the help of roll number, he's going to get the contact number. Like this, a record of that particular person is there in a form of row. So the records are being for one person, single row. In that we have lot of columns. So that columns may not be used for you, but few columns are required. So it's not like that for you, it is required two columns or three columns. I don't have to remove that. No, it can be at any time. This all columns are useful for any person at any time. So we are going to maintain the entire record. Okay. We call that as an tuple. So the tuples, we are going to create it. So in order to create, so how I'll be doing directly as I've been explaining this one in this format, I'll be using some code to create a table, which is going to help me to store the information. So I'll be have to create the schema table. Okay. How to create the schema table. So schema table, what it will going to do? It will going to store my information. So what is our ultimate target as I given the design that I had to be collect the data, I had to process, I had to store into the database. So how I'll be storing into the database in this fashion with the help of creating a table. So I have to know about the language. Now what language is going to help me to create the table is DDL language. So with the help of, so when I'm talking about this particular language, then how I'll be going to create, as I said, I need some language to store the data which I collected into the table in this format. So if I want to create the store the data in this format, I should know about DDL. This is data definition language. So it is data definition language. So I have to know about this. Now this language which is going to use to create the table. So creating the table is a structure. How the structure is there, how I'm going to know how to create the structure, what are the columns I should have, what are the records I should have, means first of all, I have to know about the structure. So schema structure, I should know. Data modeling, I should know. So this is my data modeling. So based upon this, it is clear saying, okay, you have to create this model. So I have been seeing this model. So model is, how the model is, I have the model called the entity, then I have the model as like this, say something called ID is there, color is there, okay? Then size is there, quantity is there. Then we have something called price. We have price like this. This is the model. So with this model, I want to make it into real estate. So this is a picture. So I want to make it as a model. Seeing the model, I have to create the structure. So DDL language is going to create this kind of structure for me. How it will create? It will be saying something called a create a table. Okay, table is what I need something called. Right now I'm not going in depth of this because this is a third unit of syntax. Just I'm explaining how the language will be. So I want to create the structure. So I want to create the structure. So create. The name itself it says. Then what kind of structure you want? I want the table structure. So I'm saying table. Now, what is the name of the table? I have to select the entity name. So this is the entity name. So I have to find the entity name. Then entity, what it is having some attributes. Say something called ID is there, then there's some, the color is there, there is something called any other extra columns are there. So these are all our columns. Now coming to this ID, what it is going to store? It is going to store number. So for each and every product, we have some number. So I need number. Okay. So it will going to store the number. Then color. Color will be red, green, blue, or something like this. So I'll be saying I need the distributed text format. Then quantity. So how much quantity you brought? So I got 10 or 20 quantities like this. I got, so I want to store this kind of information into this table. So if the structure is not there, how I can store the information? If I say here power bank, this is power bank of MI product. It is having some features. The color is there. This is the capacity like this. We are telling about this particular power bank. So these are the characters. This is, you are giving the information, but if I say this, what is the features of this? You'll be saying over here, okay, this is having so and so features. It is having 3 plugs or 4 plugs, then this is going to hold this much of capacity. So based upon that. So you are going to compare with this with another Power Bank. So like that, I need to be information regarding to be stored regarding this. So I need to be structure. So I have to get the structure. So for this structure, the DDL language. So I need to learn about the DMS language. The DMS language which is going to use me to create this particular structure is DDL. So how I'm going to create? I already designed the model based upon this particular model. I'm trying to take the help of the programmer, or if I know the programming skills, or if I learn the skills of language, then it is easy for me to create the structure. Now this is how I'm going to create. Now suppose I want to add tomorrow some extra column, or I don't require this particular column. Okay, so something like I want to modify this. So I'll be using something called alter. Tomorrow I don't want this structure. Totally I want to remove it. So if I want to remove the structure, I'll be saying drop. So like this, I have to know about some languages that are hidden in the DDL language. So data definition language, not Dilwale Dulhaniya Le Jayenge. It is DDL, data definition language. So with the help of this data definition language, my schema design, the data modeling has been converted into a realistic structure. So the structure is can be done with the help of this. Either I can alter it, I can modify it, or I can create it. So with the help of this, so this all comes under the DDL language. So we have to be thorough with this particular language, the third unit. Just we have to know about the concept. So like this, a schema will be going to help me to create this. So if I want to create this, I should take the help of my diagrams. I have to know about the DDL language, that is DBMS language, like send something called DDL, DCL, DCL, or whatever it is. All the language, all the different kinds of language that are available in the DBMS, we are going to use it, and we are going to interact with our software to complete our task. Okay, so this is how you're going to know about the schema objects. Okay, so views, spreads, and all the things we'll see one by one. Okay, so right now you have to understand what you mean. So in order to understand the concept of schema and the concept of design, okay, we are telling. So if you come to our database, it's a collection of raw data which has to be processed and to be stored, okay, which are in a denormalized, okay, that is what we call as a database. So with this database, I'm trying to design the database. We call that as a schema. So overall design of the database, if you create it, that becomes a schema. Then from the schema, we are trying to identify the entities. With the help of these entities, I'll try to design the structure. So once I design the structure, we call that as a data modeling. Once the design has been furnished, then we are going to know about the how you're going to use the software. So if I want to know about the software, then I should be thorough with the languages of DBMS. So this is going to help me to interact with this particular software so that I can create the structure. I can create the structure, I can modify the structure, I can add the records, I can put the restrictions, or I can write the big lines of code to store the product. That means automatically, once the person is entered, it should be triggered out. So like this, we're going to write the store procedure. So this is how the brief introduction to our database. Any doubts, you can just clarify so that I can move to the next session. Okay, any doubt, you can clarify, ma? Yeah, any doubts? You can put it in the chat box, ma'am. Yeah. Should I proceed? So till now, this is what the concept of database. Okay. So you have been creating a database. Now once you create the database, what you are doing? We are trying to make an entity. So in the database, we have to learn about the diagram. So I have to create the structure. So I have been saying that I want to create a data modeling. So if I want to create the data modeling, I should thorough with the ER diagrams. So we have to use something called ER diagrams. So this is entity relationship diagrams. So as I'm telling that data from the data, whatever the data you are collected, you have to identify the entities. So the basic concept of the collecting of data is nothing but to identify the entity. So we have been finding the entities like this. So if I want to represent this entity, I have to say that this is entity. Say entity. So example of the entity, just now I've been telling over that. So my tiffin box. So I'll be saying tiffin box. So tiffin box is an entity. Okay. I'll be saying power bank. So power bank is an entity. So whenever I'm saying the entity, it should be put it in the rectangle box. So this is what you have to do. Okay. Coming to the each entity has its similar characters or some different characters. We call this as an attribute. So entity is this one. So this is your entity. Then I have to go with the attributes. So for every entity, we have the characters. It is having some characteristics, some features. Okay. So we have some characteristics of that particular. So if I take an entity of the tiffin box, what are the attributes can we have for this, the tiffin box? I say something called, I have the attributes. So attributes in the DBMS, we are going to use something called eclipse symbol. So we are using a eclipse symbol. So how I'll be using this for the tiffin box? So example for the tiffin box. When I said tiffin box is an entity, okay, it's an entity. How I will be having the attribute? So I'll be using the eclipse. So I'll be saying eclipse is the diagram we have to use for this as an attribute. So what features this is having? It is having color. Okay, so I'll be saying color. So when I'm defining the color, it should be attribute because it's in a feature of this. So I have to put it in a eclipse symbol. Okay, oval symbol. Then I'll be saying something called, I have something called size. So bigger size, smaller size I will be having. So different size. Then I have something called price. So for each and every box I'm putting in because I want to sell it. So I have to price it. Then I have something called quantity. So I'll be having the quantity of it. So again, eclipse. Okay. Then we have something called any other extra thing. What you can have, color, size, price, quantity. And if you want anything, you can say ID. Say ID of that. Product ID. So I'll be saying product ID. So like this, I have can represent a entity within a characteristics, we call this as an attributes. So the attributes, if I want to describe, I'll be using an attribute in a form of eclipse symbol. So like this, I'll be using my attribute. Okay. Then once the attribute has been done, then I'll be having another. So I want something called relationship. So if I want to make a relationship, then I have to compare two different objects. So here I have taken something called power bank and tiffin box. So I'll be saying something called, I'll go with another object called power bank. So if it is in a power bank, again it is an entity. Then what it will be having? So it's in a name. So name is there for this power bank. Okay. Then it has the something called capacity is there. Then we have price for this. Okay, it has an ID, then some more else, etc. So like this, I have two different objects. Now, can I make these two objects link? Can this are linked to each other? So if it is linked, you can link it. If it is not linked, then you search for the other object. So it's left to you. So is the power bank is related to tiffin box, or the tiffin box is related to power bank? So like this, you are able to show the relationship between these two. So if the relationship is occurring in this, if you're able to identify the relationship between that, what the power bank will going to do with the tiffin box, or what the tiffin box will going to do the power bank. If you don't have such kind of things, then you are be trying to identify the other objects. Say something like, what is the other object we have? A paper we have, okay? Or a pen we have. So like this, I can have it. Or something like a book. Something like this, we have to identify the some other entity. So I'm be identifying the other entity. Say here, what I showed over here, I say one of our entities, something called paper, okay? So we have the paper. Again, we have something called size for this. We have something called quantity for this. And for this also, we have color, okay? So we have color, white color, we have pink color, green color. So nowadays, the papers are coming in different colors. So like this, we have another entity. So the attributes for this paper. So can I use this? Now again, this is also paper. So paper, I can say this kind of white paper, okay, or it can be plastic paper, or it can be anything. So again, there is a similarity in that. So you can have the n number of attributes, and I can create the structure. So this diagram, whatever you are seeing, these diagrams are called as an ER diagrams. Okay. So the structure, the data modeling, if you want to do it, I can go with an ER diagram. So with the help of ER diagram, I can clearly instruct the programmer. Okay. If I am the designer, I'll design the data model, and I'll be assigning this design to the programmer, saying that seeing this diagram, you try to create the software for me, or you create the table structure so that tomorrow I will be trying to enter the values. So like this, I'm going to create the entity and attributes. Now, how I'm going to link this? So if there's any link is between the tiffin and the paper, and the paper and the power bank, if it is any link is there, then you can link it. So in this relationship, I have the link called one-to-one relationship. I have a one-to-one relationship. There is something called one-to-many relationship. We have one-to-many relationship. We have something called many-to-one relationship. So I have many with one relationship. So I have many-to-one relationship. Okay. I have many-to-many. So I have something called many to many. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 is linked to 3, 1 is linked to 4, 3 is linked to 2, 3, 4 is linked to 2. So this is your many to many. So I have to identify is any relation can be established between these three objects. If it is established, if any relationship is established between these three, okay, objects or two objects, then that relationship can be 1-to-1, 1-to-many, many-to-1, or many-to-many. So I can identify the relationship between this each and objects, or the objects which have been collected. So I want to maintain the data about the papers. I want to maintain the data about the tiffin box. I want to maintain the data about power bank. Like this, I have been pictorial. I am representing this. Now this pictorial diagram we call as an entity relationship diagram. So with the help of this diagram, I am able to identify is any relationship between the entities available. If it is available, what kind of relationship is there? Is it 1-to-1, 1-to-many, many-to-1, or many-to-many? So you have to carefully, you have to understand the concept between the relationship between the each and every entity. Now, once the entity has been established, a relationship has been established, then we are going to know about the diagram for the relationship. So how I'm going to connect this two or three? So suppose paper is linked with tiffin box. How it is linked? Now, suppose I want to put a food in my box, I use the paper so that I no need to wash the tiffin box. So I'll put the paper in the box, and I'll put all the eating food over there. Then I'll get it. Once I ate it, I'll throw the paper so that I no need to wash my tiffin box. Right? So like this, I can have the established. So if I want to establish the relationship between the object to object or entity to entity, I'll be using the diagram rhombus. So what is the diagram I'm going to use? I'll be using the rhombus diagram. So with the help of this rhombus diagram, this indicates relationship, this indicates attributes, this indicates the rectangle, that is your entity. So entity is like this, attribute is like this, and rhombus symbol is relationship. So when you have, if you know that these are dependent on each other, then only I'll be using this. Otherwise, it is optional. That means I'm not going, because right now I don't require. Okay. So paper maybe I may use for the tiffin box, or the paper I may use for the something a power bank, or I may not use the paper. I am independent on my own. He is also independent on his own. He is also independent on her. So we don't require any person to dependent on me. So in that case, then I don't require the relationship diagram like this. If it is required, then I have to say that, okay, this is the so and so person is linked to this. So I'll be using this particular rhombus diagram, and I try to link two or three entities. So this is how you're going to know about the relationship. So entity relationship diagram. So you will be have something called rectangle for entity, okay, ellipse for the attribute. Then you have something called lines. We are using some arrows. Then we are using something called rhombus symbol, which is going to state me to help me to prepare the data modeling. So once with the help of this particular content, if I able to create the data modeling perfectly, then I am been using the software to convert this into a realistic language. So with the help of this diagram, so seeing these diagrams, I can able to understand, okay, this is like I am having. So if I see two or three diagrams, then I'll be going to understand, okay, entity means rectangle. So no need to mug up the content. Just seeing this, you can say, okay, if this is this so and so things have been happening, the surroundings, the entities has been identified. So the identifying the entity can be like this. It has some features. The features can be identified with Eclipse. Then I'll be writing for all the entities. I'll be writing different structures. Then I'll decide whether this can be linked to each other. If it is linked to each other, then we are calling a relationship. What kind of relationship? Is it one is dependent on other? That is this tuition box is dependent on this paper, or the paper is dependent on this? If it is like this, I'll be using 1-to-1. Is the tiffin box is dependent on the paper and the power bank? If it is depend, then I'll be saying it is depend. So it is going to say two arrows. Okay. Now suppose I'll be saying this tiffin box is depend on the paper, and the paper is depend on the tiffin box, and the tiffin box is depend on the power bank, and power bank is depend on the paper. Then in that case, what I'll do, I'll be using the concept called one to one, many to one, many to many. So with the help of this particular things, we are going to create our tables. So I have to design the schema object. So if I want to create the schema objects, I should be thorough with this particular concepts. Any doubt regarding the ER diagrams? Any doubt regarding the ER diagrams, beta? So we have this kind of relationship. So once we finish, we'll see the in the tomorrow's class. So I'll wind up the class here only. Then we'll see in the tomorrow's class. So we'll join the class tomorrow at the same time, 3:30, and also inform the others that please attend the classes. Classes are mandatory and attendance is mandatory. Okay. So any doubts, if no doubts are there, then I'll wind up the class here only.